Day 37 was all about one thing, and that was getting the BMW motorbikes as close as possible to Angkor Wat, Bayon, and Tha Prom, which are the three temples that I visited with the other BMW adventurers on day 36, the day before. We were scoping out different locations on day 36 where we could possibly get the bikes in. It wasn't clear what the rules were in terms of getting a vehicle in close to the temples. We knew that we obviously wouldn't be able to go right in, but weren't quite sure about just how close we could get. There was a lot of local traffic going very, very close to the temples, but it seemed that when we tried to do so that we ran into a few problems. As is often the case in these countries, what local people are able to do does not extend to foreigners on foreign registered vehicles. But with a bit of persuasion, we're able to negotiate our way into the east gate of Angkor Wat, which is effectively the back entrance because most tourists enter through the west gate. And we made our way pretty close to the west gate itself, which is what you see here. We got some great photographs, which I think are really priceless. We did it in a very respectful way. We pushed our bikes into location. We didn't ride them. And we took the photos as quickly as we could. Fortunately, there weren't many tourists around this area. Although tourists do tend to get a little bit irritated when they do see the bikes coming in, which sort of surprised us because we were doing it in the most sensitive way. But we got our shots, and that's what all that mattered. We then head off to Bayon, and we went through the main southern gate. Bayon is really my favourite temple. It has a great intimate feel about it, and we were able to talk to the tourist police who didn't want to let us anywhere near the temple, and we convinced them, after explaining how far we'd all ridden to be there, we convinced them to let us take a few photos on the side of Bayon. So all in all, we really were very, very lucky to get photos, which I think not many people have got. We certainly didn't see any other big BMW motorbikes around the temples that day. In fact, we didn't see any other foreigners riding bikes or driving vehicles in there at all. So it was really, really cool. I don't know whether we could have done it on our own. The fact that we had the three bikes there, I think, made a really positive impact, and you know, lots of smiles and laughing with the police, and were able to get the job done. So now I've been to Angkor Wat and the other temples twice, once in a tuk-tuk on the day one, and now the bike has visited. So very, very happy about that. Looking forward to the family arriving tonight, and then doing some more filming over the next couple of days with New Hope, Cambodia.